Pakistan may choose to ignore these voices, but Pakistan cannot wish away history, and it cannot bury one fact. Balochistan was forcefully taken by Pakistan in 1948. After giving the province autonomy for a few months, Pakistan invaded Balochistan. And it was none other than the father of Pakistan, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, who ordered this. This was a clear betrayal. Our next part tells you all about Balochistan and why Pakistan is willing to go to any extent to control it. Balochistan takes its name from the people who inhabit it. Baloch are mostly Sunni Muslim people. They speak an Iranian language called Balochi. Since independence, Balochistan has been subject to suppression. It was promised independence at the time of partition, but that promise of freedom was smashed away by Pakistan. This is how Balochistan looked before independence from British. It was a province made up of four French states: Kalat, Lasbela, Kharan, and Makran. Before partition, Muhammad Ali Jinnah floated an idea to create an independent state of Kalat, made up of all four of these provinces. A communique was released on the 11th of August 1947. It declared that Kalat will get an independent sovereign status. But in less than 3 months, Jinnah changed his mind. The father of Pakistan was unwilling to give up the region. He raised the demand, now asking the independent Kalat to formally join Pakistan. Ahmad Yar Khan, the then Khan of Kalat, refused. The standoff lasted several months. Jinnah did not listen. He demanded the accession of Kalat to Pakistan. This letter, believed to have written in February 1948, perhaps a final warning to the Khan of Kalat. Jinnah wrote, and I quote, "I advise you to join Pakistan without further delay." Later in March, the Pakistan army moved into Balochistan and captured Kalat on the 1st of April. The Khan of Kalat was forced to sign an instrument of accession. Kalat, now known as Balochistan, officially became a part of Pakistan. Balochistan is of immense value to Pakistan. If it is separate from Pakistan, then the country will be reduced to half of its present size. Balochistan is rich in natural resources like oil, gas, copper, and gold. In fact, it is the source of 36-45% of Pakistan's natural gas, which is why Islamabad is willing to go to any extent to keep Balochistan. Since its independence, Balochistan is suffering atrocities at the hand of the Pakistan military. Human rights violations are common in Balochistan. The Pakistan army is accused of detaining at least 1,900 men, women, and children.